This video lecture going to be talk about the process concepts of operating system. It is a part of the introduction of the operating system 2 under module 1. I am representing this concept in session 5 of course called operating system, and that 18 CS 43 fourth semester is a part of the computer science and engineering. So we'll quickly see the presentation flow, which the major remarkable topics which going to be covered in this video lecture. So we'll be understand the process and its concepts and the its dimension, how it originate and what its role, and how it will be contribute in the program execution. So what is a data structure for the process, what are the assistance will be taken to be the instance of the process, so continuation of the program submitted by the user to get predecided results. As we said, that process concept will increase the its different states. That is a process states. The states may be ready, it's waiting for IOs, and is running, and it terminates, and it has to be go for a queue and get some resource, so on that. So final, the program is a multiple process. So each process can have multiple threads, or single thread is a also process, right? So thread will be sub operations of that program will be splitted into. And how to schedule this process, right? So process scheduling we will going to be see in this lecture. So also, what are all the scheduling queues? Scheduling queues may be list, linked list, or some other data structure going to be encouraged to organize the queues for this scheduling the process. So scheduler communications also going to be discussed. So the how to schedule this maybe communication will be established for the different scheduling, maybe a long term scheduler, so that is a job scheduling. That is a short term scheduling, that is CPU scheduling, medium term scheduling, that is a IO scheduling, so on that different kind of schedulers we are going to be see in detail in this lecture. So also the context switch, the processor one is a raise some interrupts, so that will be control will goes to execute that interrupt, so then switch over from process 1 to that system call. Once it is completed, and it has to come back to where they sent, who has sent that control. So before coming that, he has to be collect the old history of that corresponding process, so then it will helpful to resume that. So similarly, so whenever it goes to some other process, so there it collects the their old contents, that contents, with the help of that content should resume that. So that context switching will be performed at the kernel level, right? So objective of this process management is under module 1. So there is a going to be see notations for a process of a program in execution, which forms the basis of all computation, right? All computations going to be see that. So to describe the various features of process, so process have multi dimension. What are those dimensions we will going to be see, including scheduling, that as we told that long term, short term, and we see that creation of these process, and after the job completes, it has to be kill, it has to be terminate in the sense that it has to be hand over the memory space to the operating system. So it may be use some program counter, it may be use some memory space, it may be use some registers. So all those, the once the process has created and entire tent is created, entire record is activated. So those record might consist of all those miscellaneous information which the processor have some miscellaneous. Again, program have miscellaneous. So that activation of records will be, that will be vacated as soon as terminated. It means the logical end of that process. It is completes the its job and it has to be come out from that this one and it has to be vanish. And communication protocols will going to be allied protocols going to be discussed. To explore the inter-process communication using a shared memory in some of the multiprocessor concept and message passing interface in some of the distributed, also some of the multi-computer, to describe the communication between the client and server system or master and slave process, right? So then the server and the customer, server and the user. So on that, these are the major objectives going to be considered while studying this, especially that process related. Let me begin the concept. So what is a process? So computer will run one program at a time. So before the start of the execution, when you start execution, you can think about that program submitted and it is compiled. So if no error, we'll get a object code, right? And you have to link the built-in functions, then load them, and complete exe file will be formed, right? Complete exe file. So till that point, we'll call it as a program. When start execute, so it start execute that exe file, then that program become process. So program will call it as a process, right? So that is a already transformed one, right? So we have high level language or assembly language program we may wrote. So after compiling, after linking, loading, relocating, so that will become a transparent version of the program. So that transparent version of the program, it about to yet to enter, about to, it is on the threshold, it will in the next moment it will going to be enter the execution phase. So then we'll call it as a process. So that is a process. I hope it will be demarcation between the process and the program, right? Initially user entered the problem solution through some high level language or assembly language program to the system, so called a program. When it is converted into exe code, so that become process, it going to be start execute. So in a OS executes a variety of programs, of course, that is. So the batch, in a batch system, it will execute the jobs, so multiple jobs which are identified in a particular batch. So also concept called time series system, right? So time slice, so user program or task, assume 5 programs are there, so 5 will get a equal time slots, so in the round robin fashion, so one after the each other, so everybody will be get, that is time of the CPU, right? So if it is not completed in a one slot, so it may be remaining work will perform the next slot. So like that, multiple slots will be allotted to given program, so by that time it will be get executed, so that will get a results, that is. So that time set system, so that executes the variety of programs called batch or time shared or single user, so on. That is, in the book, job and process almost interchangeably, right? So the term is, so process is a program in execution. So as we said in the beginning, program will be one program at a time executed. So the process execution must be processed in a sequential fashion. Again, we can recall Van Neumann concept. Again, we can recall stored program concept, right? So that concept is there. It is a sequential fashion. It is a one by one instruction will going to be executed. So the multiple parts will be there. So process will be multiple parts. So program code will be there, and that is a text. that is we'll call it text section. So current activity includes the program counter, so that activity increases the program counter. So processor register, right? What are all the things we have seen in the CPU, no? So those are also here. The replica of that will be there for every process. So stack is there containing the temporary data, right? So text, program counter, stack will be there. So stack function parameters return the address, local variables, so that safely stored in the special memory which is not disturbed by anybody. So that safely it kept in the locker, right? So that is a special memory. It is also be in the concept of process. So data section will be there containing the global variable, right? So text, stack, program counter, data section will also there contains the global variable. So these are the multiple part of the process, multiple parts of the process. So there is a heap containing a memory dynamically allocated during a runtime, right? So as the concepts we studied in data program, data structure, the similar concept that is extended for even process also, right? So coming to this further concept, we have gained some knowledge about a process dimension, process concept. So process multiple parts, so process instance, no? So before entering execution we'll call it as a program. After once it enter the phase of the execution, it will name will be changed, that is a process, right? So program is a passive entity, right? So program is a passive entity. So it is no role here, it is just submitting, it is a just like a non playing captain. It is submitted the job and give it to machine. Machine will take care of that. So it is stored in a disk, no? Machine will be take care of that. So when the machine start take care of that, so that will become active. That is called a process, right? So stored in a disk, executable code, process work upon that, then it become active. So program become process when executable file loaded into memory, right? So program will be change its name or changes the what is it, the cover or the structure as a process, right? When executable file loaded into memory, that is a disk, that is right. So execution of the program started via graphic user interface or mouse clicks or command line entry of its name, etc., right? So for example, VI editor there or in MS DOS, so you have to compile the program, then you will get a exe file name. So for example, program1.c, right? So after compiling will become a program1.obj. After including library files, it become program1.exe, right? So exe become a command. So put an program1.exe, program1, just say program1, it is a what is a executable file, no? So it on the command line you can execute that, so through the command line interface. Or also you have turbo editor or turbo compiler, so there we have to see some press some icons, so by clicking it will got execution, right? So that is a execution of the program via command line interface. In case of MS DOS, GUI in terms of the Windows, so on, that is, so different mode of execution of the program will be start. One program can be several process, yes, right? As I said, so one program can be several process. Consider multiple users executing the same program. So multiple users executing the same program, so that is also possible. So there is a process in a memory. You can see that what are the things are there. There is a text version will be there, so data version will be there, so that is a heap, no? That is a dynamically allocated memory will be there, so that stack memory will be there. So this is the body of the process, this is the elements of the process. So these are the contents of the major portions are the text section, data section, heap section, stack section. So all together comprises the body of the process, right? So that is a active one. This is an active one. So it can be run during mouse click or GUI or command line interface. So but one program might yield several process. So let me see the process state, right? So process state, so as a process executes, it changes its states, right? So that state of the process will be keep changing, depends upon the how fast it is executing. So new, let's say the state one is a new, right? It is a state, current state of the process, that is a process is just created. So process is being created, so then we'll call it as a new, right? So we'll call it as a new, and it's going to be admit, right? So process is created, then it is a new process, so we'll going to be admit, or we'll going to be sent for CPU, right? So requesting to execute the program. So that process ready, process is waiting to assign a processor. So just process created, now it is in a ready state, process is waiting to be assigned to a processor. Means so that process has to be acquire all resources, right? Acquire all resource, maybe input, maybe some device, maybe some the interrupts, right? So after all the resource is needed to enter into the CPU premises. So because CPU premises is very important, it is a costlier and it is a precious, no, for the precious most of the user. So it has to be make necessary arrangement, so then it has to be enter. So process is waiting to be assign a processor, means it is getting some resources, right? So ready, I hope you following. Process created, it is a newly entering into the premise of the CPU, so it will be allowed there. Once it is allowed at the gate of the CPU, it has to be thoroughly checked its purpose and ID and resource, what are all the ingredients has to be collect in order to perform that assigned process, right? So it is getting ready. So next we will go to running state. So instructions are being executed here, so certain piece of the code is allocated to the processor, so it is going to be execute. So it is running, right? It is executing now. So after getting all the resource, it going to be execute. So while executing, so there could be several problems will be occur. Again, it may be some memory contention or some division by zero or some devices will be required to display, right? So so many problems will be occur. For that, again we have to raise an interrupt corresponding and go to ready queue and get it ready and come back, right? So that is a instruction are being executed during that time, some problems will be happen. So due to that problem, that process will go into the waiting state. Process is waiting for some event to occur, right? Process is waiting for some event happen. So only that after event happen, it get that resource, and it have to be again stand in the queue of the ready who are all incoming, no? Along with them, he has to get wait in the queue, ready queue, right? So once it got a chance, then again go for the running state. So we have during waiting time, once you got that is IO wait, maybe, right? Running due to some interrupts or some IO wait, so it needs some IO, no? It has to waiting queue. So because all other processes are utilizing the IO, so scarcity of the IOs or other resource will be there. If somebody occupied that, it has to wait to some time. Whenever it become free, then it will be get acquire, and once it acquire, again it go to waiting state, right? So once it's got, that is, so scheduler would be dispatched for the running state, right? So waiting is also, so there is a what is called IO or event completion, right? So there is a completion of some waiting. So terminated, the process has finished the execution from the running state, so it has completed its job, right? So as I told, now terminated stage is means it occupied some space, it occupied some registers, it occupied some memory, so all those has to be properly has to be give it back. So termination criteria is a physical thing, but logically it has to be hand over all the resource to the operating system, then it go to the end, that is the exit phase, right? So these are the major five phases we are see that that is a process state. So process will be new, ready, right? Ready means it has to be create the records for that, and it has to acquire all resource, and it has to be run. So it if disturbance happen, if disturbance may be division by zero or any power failure, or it may be IO is not available, so that for the stage go to waiting state. Once it is acquired, you go for the ready. Again ready, in the ready several jobs are in the queue. It is maybe it has to be come via this one, and dispatch scheduler go to running. So this cycle will be performed many times, so until it process will be terminate. So this is a crystal clear concept about the different state which will be at a given instance of time process will be stand, process will be so its phase, right? So its phase. So coming to the process luggage, so you might be program might have several information that records will be there. So that what we call it as a program counter, general purpose registers, and what we call it as a MAR, MDR, stack memory, those are luggage of the program. Similarly, the allied luggage will be there. So that is a process control block. So this is a process control block is a unit of memory which maintains all the necessary luggage of the process. Each process, whenever the process creates, it took a birth, and as soon as that PCB will be created. So as I said, activation of record, that records will be, some memory will be going to be allocated for that particular process, right? So n number of process are there for a single program, so n number of process control block will be created automatically. So information associated with each process called task control block also, or process control block also, so which contains the several luggages or compartments here. So those compartments are process state. So we have seen in the previous discussion the five states of the process, that ready, new, ready, running, waiting, and terminated. So those are the states will be recorded in the PCB, process control block. So similarly, we have process ID, process number will be there, or program counter will be there. So location of instruction to execute the next instance. So instruction to execute at the next instance. So that is will be pointed by the program counter. CPU registers are there. So those contents of all process centric registers. So processor related information will going to be stored. That flag information could be some buffer registers, some information of process status, and also going to be maintained through the registers. CPU scheduling information, priorities. So scheduling queues, pointers, pointers will be there. So scheduling algorithm will be there, right? So that what we call it as short term scheduling, CPU scheduling for the process, right? So that we're going to be discussing in the subsequent slide. So that memory limits will be there. So memory management, we'll go to discuss in detail different mechanism of memory management schemes or exercise, which we'll be going to study in the subsequent discussion. That is maybe virtual memory, interleaved memory, avoiding the heaps, avoiding the holes of memory. So on concept. So accounting information, so job will be split into several pages or several blocks, so that will be CPU used, clock time elapsed since start, and time limits. So all those the statistical information will going to be maintained in the account. IO status information, so how many IO devices are connected. So I may be connected to microphone to laptop, so the mouse is connected, maybe so speaker is connected. So those IO devices allocated to the process. So list of open files we have to include there, right? So CPU switch from process to process. So multiple process are there in a program. So let we see in that scenario. So we have, let assume that process 0 and process 1. will establish the communication between them. How it will be performed and how this operating system will be cooperate, let we see, right? So process 0 start executing. It's the program which is assigned by that program. So some interrupts happen. As I told, division by 0, exceptions or memory transfer or IO disturbance, some interrupts happen. So that will be initiated by the system call. So system call is a built-in program. We have to be invoke them with help of the preprocessor. We may be hash something, include IO dot h, the conio dot h, or MPI dot h, so on that. So include those files. So from that list will be that interrupt system call will be there. So it will save the state into PCB 0. What is a PCB 0? That is a luggage of the process 0. So process control block. So what are all the information? Because it was in the premises of the P0, processor 0, it has executed certain partial part of the program. So due to that, certain results may be obtained. So that results may be in terms of this PCB going to be saved there. So save status into PCB. So the certain time is required. After elapsing certain time, and where that going, it is going to process 1 execution, right? So then get that their scenario, the process 1 scenario. So those it may be begin now, or it may be earlier slot executed, so partial execution happen. In that case, so collect the world history, so reload the state of the in from PCB 1, right? PCB 1, that PCB 1 is a the respective luggage of the processor P1. So that processor P1 luggage will be loaded here in terms of the PCB, that is a process control block 1. So once it is acquired, then it will go to the execution phase of the process P1, right? So now it is a till this point, what was doing process 1? It was idle, right? So now at this time, what P0 doing? It is idle, right? So now P1 got a chance to execute the code. So it is executed with help of the reference PCB1, old data is there. So till this point, it will execute it, and it will be reflected the result to that. So now the P1 has terminated or raised some interrupt call, right? This term interrupt call, or it may be finished that that interrupt rise by P0, so that may be also finished. So in that case, it has to be go back to process 0, right? So the context we have studying here, so process 0 rise interrupts, so that is it is there in the P1, so it will be executed in the P1. After finishing that, it has to be go back to who called he there, who called processor P0 called him, right? So he has sent some work here, it is there with the P1 premises, so it executed. Once it is completed, it has to go back to process 0. So before going that, we cannot go in a hurry. We have to record the sum of the data which is updated at the processor P1 execution phase. So save the state into PCB1, right? Once it is PCB1, then next what is the plan to do? It has to go to the process 0. So it has to be recollect the old content of the PCB0 which was saved there, which is saved in the special memory or stack memory. So we can bring that, reload the status from PCB0. So now it is going to be execute the partial remaining part of the P0. It is continued now, right? Like this, it is executing and changing to the other process which when interrupts occur, right, or any disturbance occur, it will go there and it has to be come back. So execution will be continued. So this is a CPU switch from process to process, right? So I call that P1, what is doing? That is idle. What is P0 doing when P1 is executing? That is idle. So after once P0 start executing, what P1 doing? It is idle, right? So similar model we will going to be seeing, that this system call will go to that in the premise of the kernel, right? So processes are there at the user mode. When you want to do some interrupts or give some service for some disturbance happen, for that it has to be achieved through system call. System call is only person can interact with the kernel, right? So here let we see other scenario. So I am taken an example of processor 1 and processor 2. So here we have demarcation. The above this the user mode, all these processes are there in user mode. So below that we have a kernel mode, that is a stringent space or restricted space, that is a military area, right? So that is nobody is allowed to go there. Only it is possible to go there via system call. If you have any change over the saving the states into PCB 0, load the states of PCB 1. So this kind of some sensitive work we want to perform, it has to be go to the kernel mode and it has to be performed. So let we see such scenario here. So process 1 is a is want to go to interrupt. It has occur interrupt, so it has to go to the kernel mode, right? So processor 1 need to enter into the kernel mode. So they want to do some operations. So what purpose is going? So the timer interrupt P1 is a preempted, context switch to P2, right? So that timer interrupt is there, so it go to P2. So in order to go to P2, you cannot handle over to directly P1 cannot handle to directly P2. It has to get a permission of the kernel. Via kernel only he has to be handled, right? So there is no process 1, process 2 will talk each other. So that can be bring to the notice of the kernel. So now once that the kernel is handed over to the P2, planning to hand it over, their system call trap. P2 start IO operation, blocks the content switch to the process 1. So it's given a direction, right? So once it's given a direction, so now process 2 will be perform that, so right? So IO device interrupt P2, IO complete switch to back to P2, that is, right? So now it go to the P2, right? So like that P1 and P2 will be talk each other via switching from context, that is timer interrupt P2 still has time left, so no context switch, it will be resume that execution at the P2, right? So still that P2 will be execute that. So this kind of mechanism is a exercise for how the process will be switched out from one process to other process, that communication will be established. So coming to the one more extension, thread. Thread is a single path of execution. So process have multiple paths, program have one path, right? So single path of execution and scheduled by the CPU, right? So it is under the guidance of the CPU. It has its own stack, PC, set of registers, as we see in the process control block. Similarly, stack, PC, set of registers will be a thread control blocks. So luggage of the thread, right? So luggage of the thread. So far process has single thread of execution. If no assistance for the process, it is a single process, so no thread will be there. If you want to assist for the process and their kids are their children's are the threads will be created to assist for the process. So program have multiple process, so each process have multiple threads, right? Consider having a multiple program counters per process. Multiple locations can execute at once, right? So it can execute. So multiple threads of control, that is a thread control will be there. So must then have storage for thread details too. Multiple program counters in a PCB, right? So it's have one program counter there in the process control block. So let we understand what is the difference between program and process and thread, right? How this role will be changes, right? So we have seen thoroughly program. So program, after using some editor, so you have to submit the program to the system, so that will be go and sit in the read only memory, right? So program contains the code, data, stack, right? Various aspects will be there. It is available, it is going to be temporarily accommodated at the disk, right? It is going to be sit in the read only memory, right? So this is, we understand program may be C language, program may be assembly, R may be embedded, right? So on that, so several HLL R may be assembly language program may be possible, even script program language may be possible, right? So the complete idea we have about a program, where it is reside, it is a read only memory in the disk. So let we come for the next program creates the process. So process will help to execute the program. No, so process will be a active entity. Program is a passive entity, right? So each program have multiple process which is going to be in the random access memory, right? It is a main memory, right? So we have process, right? So several process will be there. N number of process will be created for each program. So two process have shown in the in this diagram. Right, so let we begin. What is a process? It is the instance of the program. Process organization of the program in a random access memory. So process is a instance of the program. Right, so let we begin. So we have seen the process control block, the luggage of the process. What are all the details luggage which will be there? That is a PCB. Right, so again each process have their process. What I say that process has a single thread of execution. So single thread of execution is a no threads are there, so that is a process. So if need assistance to the process, then multiple threads may be possible. So these threads are in a CPU premises, right? So you can understand the concept. So program is in a read only memory, so process are in a random access memory. So whereas a process will be in the CPU, so what is a thread? Single path of execution, right? So thread is a scheduling entity. So it is a scheduling entity will be there. So the detailed discussion, the thread can share the data and may corrupt the others, that is right. So let me see that thread have process have multiple threads. So that threads will be that is so several threads are going to be here. So thread can share the data among them, but while doing what will happen, so there is a chance of erasing the other data, that neighboring thread data, so that is possible. So this thread can share the data among all the process. So this is a single path of execution. So I hope it is crystal clear. The discrimination between the program and the process also thread. Right, so this is the lowest level computations which will be at single execution, right? Single path of execution we are going to see. So let me see that process representation in a Linux, how it will happen. So process representation in a Linux, we have that is a let's see that piece of code PID, that is a process ID, TPID, process identifier will be created. So long state, so state of the process will be five states we have seen. So unsigned int time slice for scheduling information. So we have structure, so that is a structured record type, that task struct will be created. So that name is a star parent, so this process parent. So structure list had children, so this process will be children. So structure file structs files, that is a list of open files. So struct memory, that is a struct dot memory address space for the process. So here structure will be created for the each process, that is a task struct. Process information will be there, and we have again that will be created a struct, that is a process information. So here again, so n number of process will be created, structure struct the process information, and it will be coming back them, and currently executing the process here, and various such process will be created which are represented in a Linux with the C structure. Scheduling will be happening. So scheduling means multiple the competitors are utilize, user want to use that resource. So maximize the CPU says use, quickly switch process onto CPU for time sharing. At no process will be hold resource for long time, so because other processes are waiting. So process scheduler will be there. Select among available process for next execution on CPU. Among the several process we can select execution. So maintains the scheduling queues, right? So queues with help of linked list or will be maintain that links of the process, right? Job queue, set up all process in the system, right? Set up all process in the system, ready queue. So set up all process residing in the main memory ready and waiting to execute. So ready queue is waiting for the resource. So device queue, so set up process waiting for an IO devices. So device is waiting for the particular IO. Process migrates among the various queues. So process will be migrates in the sense that it change the states, ready queue and so on that. So ready queue and various IO devices queue will be see that is. So with help of the linked list, we have queue header. Queue header will be there. So queue header will be pointing to the process block. So that is a PCB7. So the logical link. So PCB have all data registers, program counters, so on that enlisted in the previous discussion. So complete template will be there. So similarly, the next PCB will be there. It will be linked. So again there. So next to no other PCB will be there. It will be grounded. It will be terminate. So from header 2, there is a PCB 2 is connected. So similarly, we have magnetic tape unit 0. So no process will be there. Similarly, magnetic tape unit 1, so no process will be there. Similarly, disk, so that is a head tail will be there. So that any the process waiting for the IO, so those are in the disk, so which are going to be in the queue. So process 3 is waiting, process 14 is waiting, 6 is waiting and is connected to link, that is, so form a circular, so that will be last one is grounded. So similarly, we have terminal monitor, it's a head, that is a display device, so the PCB5 is waiting, right? So on that, so scheduling queue, so representation of processing scheduling will be see that queuing diagram represents the queues, so that ready queue will be there, and ready queue as the process come, then it will go to the CPU door. The CPU has to be allowed them to execute. If it is need some IO, then it has to come back, go for collection of that IO, and it has to be go to the IO queue and get the IO and get serve, and after getting service, now it is ready to execute the remaining portion of the code. Again, it has to be stand in the queue. When it got a chance, then it go to the CPU, and this time it's going to be what will happen. If it is completed, it has to terminate. If not, if other problems are there, means time slice expired. In the time slice, if the process have some particular amount of time, so before that it has to be come out. It may not exit beyond that. Due to the time expire, it has to be again come back again go to the ready queue, and if it is completes, it has to terminate. Otherwise, if you need IO revise, then again it could go back. Again, time slice, then you go back. Other than this, there is also possibility fork a child, that its process have a child, that is a thread. It is to be perform that. It has to be perform. After performing a child, it has to be submit to the result to the process or parent. So parent has to be get assistance by the child. After getting assistance, after doing on behalf of that parent, the child will work, then get the result, and it has to be go back to the ready queue, and child executes that. It has to go back to the ready queue, and it has to be enter the CPU premises. So like that, there is also wait for any interrupts. If division by zero, power failure, or any happens, exceptions happen, for this that reason also, it has to be come out from the CPU. So it has to be execute that interrupts, and it has to be again come back to execute the remaining part of the program. So ready queue. So that is a complete task will be going to be performed. That is. So schedulers, we have what is called short term scheduler. So CPU scheduler is called as a short-term scheduler. Select which process should be executed next and deallocate CPU. So the decision will be taken by this CPU scheduler. So short-term scheduler, which process should be go for execution and which process we need to be stop. Sometimes the only scheduler in a system, short-term scheduler is invoked frequently in terms of milliseconds must be fast, right? In the fraction of second, it has to be decision. So long term scheduler, that is a job scheduler, so that is a program scheduler, that selects which process should be brought into the ready queue, right? So that job scheduler, which process. So long term scheduler is a invoked infrequently, that in terms of seconds, minutes may be slow compared to the job that CPU scheduler. This long term scheduler controls the degree of multi programming. So degree of multi programming will be impacted here. So process can be described either here. So IO bound process, right? IO bound. So spends the more time doing IO than computations. So many short term CPUs burst, that is, right? So it is neither in the short term or long term, it is a medium term. So CPU bound process spends more time doing computations, few very long CPU burst cycle. So long term schedulers strives for good process mix, that is, right? So coming to this, that is a medium term scheduling. So that is added if degree multiples program need has to be decreased. So remove process from a memory, store on a disk, and bring back into from the disk to continue execution. So that is a swapping mechanism, right? So we can put temporarily that process in a stack, so then give it to somebody the chance. So in that queue sense, we have ready queue and we get a CPU, and it lucky enough, then this may be completed. If no disturbance, IO or time slice or interrupts, then it will be lucky, will be come out, it will be end. So many times it may not so, because this today's computers, which will be have heterogeneous bound instructions in a program. Program might be considered computationally intensive, memory intensive, IO intensive, so on that. Since it's heterogeneous, it avoids that such easy ending. It may always we have to go for wait. So IO waiting will be there. So after getting IO, IO perform operations, then go into ready queue. Similarly, there is a swap out, no? Swap out. So that immediate medium term scheduling. So remove the process from memory, because that process is unnecessarily making delay, in the sense that it is waiting for some non-coming resources. It takes time, individual time. In that case, temporarily you can suspend that process, put it in aside into the memory, swap out, then get the partial executed swapped out process. Then you have to coming, that is swap in. So earlier which is suspended, that we can take it to consider. Now the old one will coming in a ready queue, it going to be there, right? So the short term, long term, medium scheduling, let we see in very more diagrammatically. So here we have start a jobs are there, right? Jobs are entered. So jobs are in a queue, that is a long term scheduler. So that is in terms of seconds and so on. It will be there. It reduces the degree of multi-programming due to the more time will be there. So ready queue will be there in the memory, right? So those jobs will be enter into the ready queue. So these jobs will be going to enter into the CPU premises. So that will be become a short-term scheduler. So that waiting for the CPU. So this is the most important junction where it will be there. It has to be previously used that. If it is enough lucky, if no waiting, no stacks, no what we call it as a time slice, so on, that is, it will be end. So as I said, the current instances will increase the heterogeneous instruction in the program. So that's why it may not possible in a quite easy way to execute, right? So let we see what other problems. That is IO request we said. So that is a IO drive. Again, many devices are in the queue for the particular IO. So it is IO device will be get chance, and it will get serve, and it has to be come back, and it has to be entered into the ready queue. So coming to the other, that is a fork, that is a child will be there. So that is thread will be there. So that child will be do on behalf of the parent. So after executing that piece of work which is outsourced by the process, so that will be completed. Again, it will go back to ready queue and go to the chance of the getting a CPU premises. And the other possibility, the interrupts are time slides, so on that is, so that interrupts occur had to be get served and go back and come to the ready queue. So here we can observe that, so this will be indicates the job that is a long term scheduler in terms of seconds, so on that. We have short term scheduler in terms of seconds, right? In terms of seconds, there milliseconds, sorry, here maybe in terms of seconds, and sorry, this is milliseconds, this is in terms of more number of seconds, right? So this is a milliseconds, or so on that is. So where we have other, we have fork, wait for IO and slime slice will be medium term scheduling. We have seen that. So that is the difference. We can observe long, short and medium term process scheduling, right? So that we have that swap out some of the processor hangover due to the non-coming resource. So necessarily you can temporarily suspend it, put it in a disk. If somebody is there in the old process, old earlier suspended process, we can take them and ask them to come into ready queue and get executed. So we have observed the all scenario related to the short time, long term and medium term. From this diagram, we are clearly able to understood that what are the different type of schedules are there, what is their range, short, long and medium range, right? So coming to the multitasking in a mobile system, some mobile system are especially that hybrid iOS, Apple, Macintosh, so allow only one process to run, so others are suspended. So if we not encourage multiple one, so due to the screen real estate, user interface limits iOS provides, that is, so the limits of the screen will be there. So single background process controlled via user interface, there is only one foreground, so screen, that is a foreground user, that which will expose to the real world. So that is a monitor or the display device. So multiple background process will be there. So the background process may be one process at the foreground and multiple process at the background, which are memory running but waiting for queue but not on the display. So that display is a foreground with its limits, that is. So limits include the single short task receiving notifications of the events, specific long running task like audio playback, and those will be there. Android runs foreground and background with a fewer limits. iOS have some limits that. So background process uses the service to perform a task that. So service to process that. So service can keep running even background process is suspended process also will keep track, that is. Service has no user interface, right? Small memory it is utilized. So context switch we have studied in the previous one. So when CPU switches to the another process, the system must save the state of the old process. So that we have seen the state of the saving of PCB 0 and getting the process of PCB up 1, where it is going. After once complete that job, it is had to come back to where it is sent. So recollect that earlier process. So save the state for that process. So and load the saved state for the new process via context switch. So context switch, that is a process represented in a PCB in terms of thread, that is TCP. Context switch time is overhead. So the system does no useful work while switching, that is. So it is just it is in the dilemma, it is waiting for securing time will be there, no? So more complex the OS and PCB, the longer the context switch. So situation become tough when the longer context switch. So time dependence on hardware support also. So some hardware gives the multiple sets of register per CPU. So those can be speed up the context switching. So multiple context loaded at once, that is. So restatement, we can summarize that. So for the concepts to discuss. So we discuss the process concept. It is motivated from the program concept. So program was a passive, process is a active. So it have several states, that is a new, ready, running, waiting and terminal. So threads are there. So we can process, can outsource some piece of the work, or can take a help, or like a threads. So thread is a child. The process scheduling will be there. So process scheduling will be at the CPE premises. So that is a short-term scheduling that happen in terms of the milliseconds, right? So scheduling queues will be there. So as long as that multiple process demanding the devices, so like that the devices has to be stand in the queue. After getting their chance, I have to use those IO devices. Then once it is completed, it has to be again stand in the ready queue, right? So schedulers communication, we have seen that through the context switch. So that long term scheduling, short term scheduling, so medium term scheduling, that is IPO, swap in swap out, swappers will be there. Medium term, the short term or the CPU scheduling, process decision, so which processor has to be select now next, right? That is a long term, that is a job scheduling, so which are the process we need to be create and design. So context switch mechanism, we have seen in that. So we have drawn this material from the textbook called Abraham Silbert Charge et al. The reference book many, that is Phelan and Damdare, and we have Butt and also Stalling. So these materials are available, and we can get some material. Apart from this, also magazines, internet, and also possible. Thank you for patient listening and shown an interest on process scheduling, queues, communication, and context switch concept as a part of the Module 1. We are putting it in the session 5. Thanks to coordinator, moderator, subjects, expert. Thank you, one and all.